the decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled, Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was the child. While they were there, time came forth for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. There are many of you in this congregation who think to yourselves, if only I had been there, how quick I would have been to help the baby. I would have washed his linen. How happy I would have been to go with the shepherds to see the Lord lying in the manger. Yes, you say that because you now know how great Christ is. But if you had been born there at that time, you would have done no better than the people of Bethlehem. Childish and silly thoughts these are. Why don't you do so? You have Christ in your neighbors. You ought to serve them. For what you do to your neighbor in need, you do to the Lord Christ himself. There, in a stable, lay the Creator of all the world. And there was a maiden of 15 years or so bringing forth her firstborn without water, fire, light, or pan, a sight of tears. Mary and Joseph must have marveled that this child was the Son of God. He was also a real human being. He was a true baby with flesh, blood, hands, and legs. He slept, cried, and did everything else that a baby does, only without sin. The birth was still more pitiable. The guests swarming in the inn were carousal. No one attended the woman. And now think what Mary could use for swaddling clothes. Some garments she could spare, perhaps her veil. Certainly not Joseph's trousers, which are now supposedly on exhibit at the church in Mocking. Mary was not only holy, she was also the mother of the Lord. With trembling and reverence, before nestling him to herself, she laid him down because her faith said to him, he will be the Son of the Highest. No one else on earth had this faith, not even Joseph, for although he had been informed by the angel, the word did not go to his heart as to the heart of Mary, the mother. Now is overcome the power of sin, death, hell, and guilt. If you come to this gurgling baby and believe that he is come not to judge you,